He recover your sin. Don't find you how. Don't hide from God, 'cause he knows all things. He recover your sin. Don't find you how. Don't hide from God, 'cause he knows all things. Listen. Don't send the altar with the blood of sin. Let the fire the altar, the blood of sin. Blood on the altar. Blood on the altar. Recover your sins to find you are. You walk away from God, he knows all things. Don't make the altar and the blood of sin. Don't defy the altar.
This is Pastor Wilson, sir. Please do not switch off your phone, sir. It's important I talk with you.
Are you there, sir?
Reverend Hosea, are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Good. That's it. I've been trying to
get you on phone for the past 2 hours, but I guess probably you switched off your phone.
Anyway, I would like to make my stand and conviction known to you regarding all the past incidents, sir.
Sir, you see, I believe the word of God.
As it is written in Ephesians 5:11-13, that we should not partake in the works of darkness, but rather expose them.
Are you hearing me, sir?
Yes.
Pastor
Wilson. Did they come alone?
Yes.
I see. Go. Then go and tell him that I'm coming.
Let us go and see him now.
Us? Did they say he wants to see us together?
He said he want to see you.
Go and tell him I'm coming. I said, then go and tell him I'm coming. What has he come to do at this time? Eh? I thought this is all over.
Oh my God.
What is going on?
I'm so sorry, sir, to have disturbed your sleep. I learned you are resting upstairs.
No. Never mind.
Yes, sir.
Never mind. So how is the ministry doing?
The Lord is helping us, sir.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Yes, sir.
Pastor Wilson, what brought you here this evening?
I wanted to see you to have a few discussions with you, sir.
I see.
Yes, sir.
So where can we talk?
Anywhere, sir.
All right. Sit down.
Thank you, sir. Ma. You would have to excuse us, ma'am.
This matter is all over. Huh? Oh my God. What do you want? All right. What do you want to talk about? What do you want to see me for?
Thus saith the Lord thy God. I anointed you a minister in my household. I delivered you from all your enemies round about you. I gave you a flourishing ministry and a peaceful home. And yea, I decided to do much more. Why have you despised the word of the Lord God to do such great evil in his sight? You have lain with your neighbor's wife in adultery and have killed with the sword of abortion. And you have not feared the Lord thy God in making several attempts to cover it up and still sacrifice upon my altar. You have brought discredit to my church and you have caused the world to jeer at Christ. You have not only broken the laws of thy Lord thy God, but you have also broken his heart. Thus saith the Lord thy God, whom thou hast despised and ridiculed. I am tired of your offerings and despise your sacrifice. Since you have decided to sacrifice your years of labor on the altar of adultery, your ministry is taken away from you and burnt into ashes. Put your house in order, for thou shalt die tomorrow.
On two occasions, I had sent for her to meet me at my hotel room when I had traveled. When she came to inform me that she was pregnant, I persuaded her to abort it.
Hey!
Jesus Christ.
Honey.
My God.
I gave her 100,000 naira to evacuate it.
God!
The evacuation was badly done by whoever did it. And that was why she died. That was why she died.
God.
Oh my God.
God.
That is the evil that I have did to my God. That is the evil that I did to my God. I have despised his grace. And I have scorned this favor. Oh my God. I have dragged his precious name in the mud.
Oh God.
I have sinned against his holy name. Oh my God. I don't know why. I don't know why it has taken me so long to open up and to surrender at his feet. I don't know why. Look at the evil that I have done to myself. Now that pastor has prophesied that I need to put my house in order.
No! 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 No!
He said, I shall die tomorrow.
Don't say that again. Don't say that again, Lord. Don't say that.
Perhaps the Lord will spare my life now that I have confessed. Yes. Oh my God. What evil have I done to myself? 30 years of ministry flushed down the drains just like that. Oh my God. Just like that? Ha!
Oh, Lord.
God, have mercy.
So what is this standing in the gap, Lord?
Have mercy, Lord.
Your blessing is immense, Lord God.
Mercy,
I don't want this man to die. Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy.
Forgive, Lord.
Have mercy, Lord.
Lord, please have mercy.
Your will for me will always come to pass if I concentrate and focus on you alone.
Lord,
and when I see you are willing to forgive, as I confess and trust in
that
you
will show
alone.
Him mercy.
Lord. Lord, you will be favorable to his wife and his only begotten son.
Lord, we plead for mercy. Lord, we plead for mercy. And you let him live, oh God. Show him mercy, Father.
Lord, please. Have mercy on him, oh Lord, and forgive him all his sins. Lord, we pray that we spare his life, oh God. Please, 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 Lord. Spare his life. Spare his life.
In the name of Jesus, oh God.
In that blood of Jesus, please, please, show him mercy.
Please, Lord, forgive him, oh Lord, and show him mercy.
Lord, forgive him.
My God, is it really true that I am dying tomorrow? Is it really true, Lord? Oh my God. I know I have wounded your heart, Lord. I know that I have despised your grace upon me. Oh my God. I know that I have dragged your name in the mud. My God. God, you are a great savior. Turn your anger away from me, Lord. Have mercy, Lord, have mercy. I am sorry for all my sins. I am sorry, Lord. I am truly sorry. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me all the sins. Oh my God. keep me, daddy. Oh. Forgive me, daddy. Let your anger and your wrath be turned away from me. I'm sorry for every sin that I have committed, daddy. Baba, you're welcome. You're welcome, Baba.
Man that is in honor and understand this not, it's like a beast that perish.
Baba, is it true that I will die tomorrow?
Why are you afraid of dying?
Oh my God, Baba. It's just that I am not prepared for it yet. I am not prepared for it.
Are you sure you are not prepared to die?
Yes, Baba. So many visions, Baba. Yet to be realized, Baba. So many lands to be captured for the Lord God. Baba, several ministry ideas that will help to liberate millions of souls. Baba, I don't want to die now. I don't want to die now, Baba.
You are talking about the visions that are yet to be fulfilled. But even the ones that have been done have been destroyed already.
Oh my God. Ah! Oh my God. 30 years of ministry.
Yes. Oh. You have just destroyed it yourself.
Ah! Ah! Oh, Lord. Won't you forgive me, Lord? Would you? Your Lord that is merciful and gracious. Lord, you are long-suffering and abundant in goodness and in truth. You are the God that keeps mercies for thousands. You forgive iniquity, transgressions and sin.
Yes. Yeah. And will by no means clear the guilty.
Oh my God. Lord, you have to forgive me these errors.
I have forgiven you.
Lord, I don't want to die. I don't want to die, Lord.
Will you be able to withstand the impending shame, disgrace, and affliction that this sin will bring upon you?
Oh my God.
Your ministry is gone, son. Your life has been cut short. David was a man after my heart. When he did a similar thing, he asked for forgiveness of his sin, and I forgave him. But do you know what I told him? In 2 Samuel chapter 12, verse 12, I said, even though he committed the sin in secret, I will expose him before all Israel and before the sun.
Ah, my God.
Can you remember the shame and disgrace he went through, including losing his four eldest sons with Ammon, the crown prince?
Ah.
He spent the remaining years of his life in distress and calamities.
Oh, my God.
You will not be able to handle what lies ahead of you.
Lord, I am deeply sorry for this errors, Lord.
The enemy has triumphed over you to some extent. He has cut short your ministry and made a mess of your 30 years of labor in the vineyard. So, taking you away from the field of the game is to save you from further affliction of the enemy. Your wife and your son will still scale through because they are innocent and I will favor them. So, give me the scepter.
But why, Lord?
I'm taking it away from you You've got no ministry anymore.
Ah!
I'm taking the authority of the ministry from your hand.
Oh my God.
So, give it to me.
Ah!
Keep the fire. That is all trance. You will still deliver a message.
Lord, my Lord.
Lord, dear, dear.
Yes.
Praise God.
Where am I? Where is this place?
Hospital.
Hospital? But what happened?
Shh. You just need to relax now, okay? Relax.
What? Please. What happened? Why am I in this place?
Remember we were in the room yesterday night?
Yes, yes.
And I was sitting on the bed with you.
Yes.
You were shouting and crying and praying. All of a sudden you just went unconscious. You fainted and that's all. I screamed. I prayed. I did all I could but you never came around.
Oh my God.
The gate man and I rushed you here.
Oh my God, me? Just fainted?
The doctor said you were having high blood pressure.
High blood pressure?
He even said he need to run some tests on you.
I see. But where is David?
He just left this place now. He should be at the reception.
I see.
How are you feeling now?
I'm having a severe headache.
Sorry.
You cannot hide it from God.
Sorry.
You may cover your sins and say nobody knows. You cannot hide it from God.
No. No. No, 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 no. Not so soon. No, not so soon. Look, his death will not be of advantage to anybody. We have prayed. We have prayed. And the Lord will answer our prayers.
Amen.
Amen.
When did the woman say he was taken to the hospital?
She said yesterday night. That he fainted and became unconscious while he was praying.
Jesus.
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Pastor Wilson, it's me.
Oh, hello, ma. Yes, I know. How is he faring?
He's beginning to ask of some people. He particularly asks of you. He wanted to come and see me.
Pastor
Wilson, I was there yesterday when the word of knowledge was coming out of your mouth. I was there yesterday when he was told he would die today. But Pastor, can't you pray? He has asked for forgiveness of sin. He has asked God for mercy, not forgiveness. He has confessed his sin. Can't you join your faith with mine? I don't want this man to die.
All right, ma'am. I will be there shortly.
Thank you.
Check Mr. Clemente Wes's number for me. I need to confess to him too. Call his number.
But will he be able to bear it?
Honey, I have a duty to fulfill. I must have to smooth in all the rough edges. I need to confess to him too. Call his number.
He's ringing.
Good. Tell him.
Tell him what?
Everything. No. Let me tell him myself.
Yes. Who is this, please?
This is Reverend Atilade Osia, calling from Lagos.
Ah, good evening, sir. It's so nice to hear your voice again. How is mommy?
I have a confession to make.
Confession? What confession?
Huh. I admit it was a terrible thing that is not expected from someone like me. You see, I was overtaken by the enemy and I fell for the trap.
What's going on, sir?
I must have hurt you deeply. I must have inflicted a lifelong wound on your heart. But please, it is only one thing I ask of you. Find a place in your heart to forgive me.
What have you done to me?
I was responsible for the pregnancy of your wife. Hello? Hello?
What?
He has cut off. He must have been too shocked.
Bring the phone. It's ringing.
Hello.
You said you were responsible for the pregnancy to me about it?
Mr. Clement, I know you have every right to be angry. But please forgive me. Hello?
It's off again.
It's off again.
That's all. You've told him enough. Bring the phone. You need rest, please.
I need to inform the house of God too. Get me Reverend Dr. Billy Vincent. I need to tell him too.
You want to tell the president of the Pentecostal Ministers Association?
want to call him, to tell him to call a press conference and to announce my expulsion from the Pentecostal Association.
No, you can't do this. You have repented. You have asked God for forgiveness.
Get him for me. I am acting under instructions. Let him begin to make a public announcement of all ministers of God who drag the name of the Lord God in the mud. Get him for me.
Oh God.
Brother, what is the matter?
Have found him.
Who?
The murderer. The man who impregnated my wife and pushed her to commit abortion to cover up his misdeeds.
Who is he?
Reverend Osia. Atilade Osia.
Reverend Osia.
Reverend Osia. Reverend Osia of Pentecostal Association. In Lagos.
I don't care what association he belongs to. He just called me some minutes ago to confess.
Hey, bro, blame me.
I can't believe this.
You see my predicament? I pushed my wife out of my home because of a strange woman, not knowing that I was pushing her into the hands of a strange man. You see my life?
Brad Clemens, calm down. Calm down, eh?
This is strange. Can you imagine this happening in the house of God? When I heard that my wife was working in a church office with a man of God, I was happy, thinking that at least she is safe from the usual madness of the world. But I was deceiving myself. I never knew she was employed by the devil's agent himself. This man slept with my wife, impregnated her, pushed her to commit abortion, and she died in the process. This evil man was there with me in the hospital, at the deathbed of my wife, when I was weeping sorrowfully. When I went to take custody of my son, I went to his house to thank him for all his support. This man saw me in my agony, yet he kept mute. Can you imagine the hypocrisy in the church? I never knew the devil man lives in the church.
Bradley,
no.
Don't say that. Be calm.
No. I will say it. I will tell the whole world how a man of God ruined my life. I'm going to call my boss in Lagos. I will get him arrested. I will sue him and ensure that he's jailed for this.
Bradley, let the Lord handle this matter.
Leave the world out of this. I will handle it myself. I will handle it my own way. Don't you know what he has done? He has made me a widow and my son motherless. The whole world was here about this. The whole world was here how the evil that a supposed man of God has done.
Bro Clement.
No. Sorry, man. I am not Bro Clement. I am a naval officer. Lieutenant Commander Clement Owese. Good day.
Reverend Vincent, don't bother to pray for me. Don't even worry about me. I know my hand. And I know it is not in the Lord's intention that this ministry should die. It's all my making. Reverend Vincent.
Yes.
I have made a confession. I delayed for so long. Oh my God. I have told you everything. Now, I have no ministry anymore. And the labor of 30 years have all been rubbished by by that simple little sin. I am guilty of adultery, of abortion, and of the murder of a lady who ran away from marital crisis to take shelter under the ministry that the Lord has given me. Oh my God. I have called her husband and opened up to him. And I've also asked him to pardon me for the deliberate evils.
But how will the people feel when they hear this?
I have tried to cover up these things. It has never worked. So, it will never work for whoever tries to cover it. It will never. The Lord has said that the time has come that they will begin to purge his church and prepare her for his second coming. He said he will begin to judge the priests of his house and those who have desecrated his holy altar. He said he will begin to bring them all to justice. The Lord said he will beat them with the rod of afflictions. It is time, says the Lord, that he will arise against all those who profess religion and not relationship to God. And all that are given is enemies' reasons for reproach and blasphemy. Yes, the time has come. The time has come, says the Lord, that those who soil my altar shall bear the shame of it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Reverend Vincent, call a press conference and tell the whole world that I am sorry. But don't forget to tell them that the Lord has forgiven me. Yes, he has forgiven me of the great evil. I have labored in his vineyard for 30 years. Yes, and all the works are burnt. I'm going back to him with the ashes of the labor of 30 years. Oh my God.
Oh God.
The Lord and his mercy has said that they will make my wife and son to scale through the sorrowful moments. Oh my God. I leave them all in his care. Thank you all.
A suspect is hiding here.
No suspect is hiding in this hospital.
Oh, he is a suspect. Only pretending to be a patient here.
Listen, doctor. These officers are here to arrest Reverend Osea. He has discovered that his secrets are leaked and so he's pretending to be sick in order to avert judgment.
No, he was brought here yesterday night after fainting during a prayer session. I examined him and find out that he has high blood pressure. So he has been placed on admission.
Doctor, you have been fooled. All right. Can we see him?
Okay, let's go and see him.
Hello? Yes, sir.
and location, sir. Yes, sir. Are they in position, sir? Yes, sir.
Come right, please.
All right.
As you can see, he's resting.
Brother Clement.
These are his people who have come to see him.
Doctor, this man has to wake up. He has to confirm what he confessed to me on the phone.
No, we can't wake him up. We have to wait for him to wake up.
Brother Clement, you can ask me whatever question you want to ask him.
No. This officer has to hear him speak.
Reverend Osea. Reverend Osea. What is it, Doctor?
What is it, Doctor?
Are you all here? You didn't know.
What is it?
Don't tell me that.
I'm sorry.
Jesus!
Reporting live from the alleged hideout of the Reverend, a hospital. We're hoping this time to get his own side of the story. We have reports that the police are here with the husband of the deceased woman. As you can see, there were a dull countenance. Probably the Reverend has been taken under arrest. But he doesn't seem to be being led by them. Well, viewers, let's find out from the police what exactly is going on. Good afternoon, sir. We see you coming out of the hospital where the suspect is said to be hiding, but we don't see you leading him out. Have you been convinced otherwise? What exactly is going on?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, we are unable to arrest the man. We got his word and we found him dead.
Dead?
Yeah.
Are you sure he was dead? Are you sure this is not a smoke screen to avoid getting arrested?
No. You see, the doctor was there and the doctor confirmed him dead. Apart from that, there were some of his relatives on ground who witnessed the incident and they were equally amazed that the man is dead.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is amazing. Well, sir, before you go, isn't it possible for you to rule out the possibility of suicide to avoid embarrassment?
You see, ladies and gentlemen, until autopsy is carried out and further investigations are made, we may not be able to give additional comments on these. So if you will please excuse us, we'll appreciate you.
Thank you very much.
But before you go,
Thank you, gentlemen.
Sir, is it true that Reverend Osia is dead?
Will this not damage the integrity and the reputation of the church?
Sir, is this not one out of the many instances that we obtained in the church today?
Sir, will this not hinder the growth of the church? Sir, we feel that Reverend Osia committed suicide. Is it not true?
No comment.
Surely you must say one
out. Sir, what's the cause of justice against the church on this matter?
Would you be giving us a rest?
What about his wife and his children, sir?
Okay, we think it's your wife and the members of the family.
One more question, just one more question. What would happen to his wife?